Hi guys, how are you? Hope you are doing good. Welcome back to my channel.
Today, let us discuss the important topic, growth stages of maize. Earlier, we discussed growth stages of rice and wheat. Now, we are discussing about growth stages of maize. And it is a cereal grain which was first grown by the people in ancient Central America. It is now the third most important cereal crop in the world. Maize is a leafy stalk whose kernels have seeds inside, and it is very most important crop. In addition to being consumed directly by humans, often in the form of masa, maize is also used for corn, ethanol, animal feed and other maize products such as corn starch and corn syrup. The six major types of maize are dent corn, field corn, pod corn, popcorn, floor corn and sweet corn. Now, let us discuss about the growth stages of maize in detail. Some of these stages are vegetative stages and reproductive stages. The vegetative stages include emergence, which termed as VE, V1, first leaf stage, V2, the second leaf stage, V3, third leaf stage, VN, nth leaf, VT as tasseling stage. And this is all the vegetative stages and representing the V. And reproductive stages is represented by R. R1 silking stage, second stage is R2 blister stage, third stage is R3 milk stage, and R4 dough stage, R5 as dent stage, R6 as physiological maturity stage. Before going to the growth stages of maize, let us discuss some of the parts which are included in the maize. Let us see the roots. Roots like lateral seminal roots, radical nodal roots, and we have the mesocotyl. After that, coleoptile, which arises from the soil and bearing the first leaf sheath. You can observe here in the image, it is showing the first leaf sheath, first leaf collar, and first leaf blade. Here you can clearly observe what are the sheath, collar, and blade. And this is the soil surface. Before going to the growth stages of maize, some people are asking about the PDF. I will give this PDF in the description box and you can observe it and study carefully and grow the knowledge of the maize crop. In the growth process of the maize, we can see the seed, how it is emerging, and coleoptile, and you can see the collar and the leaves above the soil surface, and the plant is growing. The vegetative stages are some of the stages which are described using the leaf collar method, which is defined by the number of collars on the plant. Leaves are counted from the lowermost part and to the uppermost leaf with the leaf collar, which is the connection between the leaf blade and the leaf sheath. The leaves in the whole that are not fully expanded or not counted. Let us discuss about the emergence. Here you can observe in the image the emergence of the plant. The coleoptile leaf, the first leaf visible, this leaf will be shorter than the lateral emerging leaves and has the rounded tip. The growing tip of the plant should be 1 to 1.75 inches below the soil surface, and the seminal roots begin growing from the seed. The permanent nodal roots, here you can observe the nodal system, will begin developing at this point. If the seed is planted too shallow, the root system will have a difficult time becoming established. The second leaf stage. Let us discuss about what is the second leaf stage. The collar of the first true leaf, not the coleoptile leaf, is visible in this stage, and the plant is still relying primarily on the seed resource for the survival. This is the second leaf stage of the grain of the maize. Next, coming to the third leaf stage, we will be seeing the three leaves and it is showing that the growing point is below the soil surface. Frost on the surface will not kill the plants. Freezing soil temperature will kill the plants. Flooding can kill the plants. So care should be taken. Flooding should not occur in this crop. And root hairs begin to form on nodal roots, and seminal roots growth has basically stopped. Here you can see that on the nodal roots we are seeing the root hairs in this third leaf stage of the maize crop, and the collar of the third leaf is visible, occurs appropriately at 10 to 14 days after the emergence, and growing point below the soil surface. The plants total leaf number and ear shoots are developing in the stalk. The photosynthesis is now very active and supporting the plants, having the leaves, and may apply 2,4-D or dicamba from emergence through the fifth leaf stage without the drop nozzles. And coming to the next stage, 4th leaf and 5th leaf stage. We have the 4th leaf stage. We can observe the collar of the 4th leaf visible and the growing point below the soil surface. Roots are elongating. The root system is not primarily nodal roots. Weed competition will begin to significantly reduce the soil potential in the 4th leaf stage of the maize. And 5th leaf stage of the maize, we can observe the collar of the 5th leaf, and it may have lost the coleoptile leaf by this time at the 5th leaf stage. The leaf number and the ear shoot formation will be completed in this stage, and the plant is approximately about 8 inches tall in 5th leaf stage. The growing point is just below the ground surface, and the hair or light frizz will cause little long term damage to the plant. However, the flooding while the growing point is below ground can kill the plant, so flooding should not happen in the crop. So it can kill the plant, especially if the temperatures are high. The first internode to elongate is about 13 mm long and is located just below the node to which the leaf 5 is connected. This is most important reference for the crop growth staging, and tassel formation has been initiated in the 5th leaf stage, you should observe. And ideal growth stage to side dress nitrogen. Nitrogen uptake begins to increase at V5. That is 5th leaf stage. This is a good time for the supplement of the dose of nitrogen so that it is an available form to meet the requirements for the development of the crop. Here in the 6th leaf stage, you can observe the collar of the 6th leaf and occurs approximately 3 weeks after the emergence. The growing point and the tassel above the soil surface, making the plant more vulnerable to hail or frizz. The permanent root system rather than the seminal roots is now the primary root system supporting the plant, and the root system extends approximately 18 inches in the 6th leaf stage. And here you can observe the tillers may developing at this stage, and internode elongation also occurs in this 6th leaf stage. And continue to check the roots for western corn rootworm larvae. Continue to check for small colonies of banks, grass, mites. It may affect the crop at this stage. So this stage you should be careful and observe all these mites and larvae is occurring or not. As we discussed earlier about the 6th leaf stage, you can see here in the image we are having the ear root. Growing point is above the ground level, and the nodal system will be playing a primary root system for the nutrients and the water, and also the development of the premature tassel also observed in the 6th stage, as you can observe here in the image like this. After the 6th leaf stage, you can observe the 7th leaf stage and the 8th leaf stage. where we are having the 7-leaf stage, we can observe the color of the 7-leaf, 7th leaf, and the plant beginning to the grow rapidly and fast. The number of kernels also grow, kernel rows being determined from the V7 to the V8, maximum row set by the 8th leaf stage. And in 8th leaf stage, you can observe the color of the 8th leaf, and it approximately of 45 days after the emergence may have lost lower 2 leaves. Do not side dress after this point, or root damage may occur. Check upper and lower surfaces of the leaves for western, southwestern and European corn borers, eggs or small larvae. No longer advisable to apply insecticides for western corn rootworm control. In the 9th leaf stage, you can observe the color of the 9th leaf, and also the ear shoots are visible in the leaf color. Regions may have up to 8 ear shoots. The tassel is rapidly developing, and corn borer feeding damage should be evident on leaves and in the whorl of the infected plants. Here you can observe in the 9th leaf stage, the growth rate rapidly increases in this stage, and the greater the demand for the nutrients and the water in this stage mainly, as it is the growing point of the crop. Here you can observe the 10th leaf and the 11th leaf stage. In the 10th leaf stage, the color is visible of the 10th leaf, and new leaf stage occurring every 3 to 4 days. Water and nutrient requirements are high. Continue to check for the bank grass, mites, infestations on the lower leaves. In the 11th leaf stage, the color of the 11th leaf is visible and may have lost the lower 3 leaves, and a few corn borers will have entered the stalk by this time. No longer the feasible to apply insecticides for the corn borer. Coming to the next stage, that is leaf 12th leaf stage. You can observe here in the 12th leaf stage, we are having the both kernel size and the kernel number are being determined. Any limits on water or nutrients at this phase will drastically impact the yield. As in this stage, the water and nutrients are most important. If the water and nutrients are less, there may be reduced in the yields. So, the care should be taken to give water or nutrients at this stage. The earlier maturity hybrids will pass through this phase faster than later maturing hybrids. And number of kernel rows already determined. The top ear is still smaller than the lower ear shoots. Coming to the 13 to 17 leaf stage, V13, V17 stage. Leaf stages at 13 to 17 will develop very rapidly. At some point, the tip of the tassel will be visible, and the leaf stage occurs vary between the hybrids, and silks will begin to grow as the tassel is emerging. This is the most important point to note, that silks will begin to grow as the tassels are emerging. As already tassels are emerging, the silks also will be begin to grow. The early maturity hybrids progress from 13th leaf stage through the 17th leaf stage. The faster than the later maturing hybrids and have smaller ears. This can be compensated by higher seed rate. Next, the attempt should be made to have the soil profile full of water prior to tassel emergence. The care should be taken that the water profile should be with the full of water before the tassel emergence, as the brace roots developing from the 6th node, and V17 is approximately about 8 weeks after the emergence. You can observe the V15 at 8 weeks after the emergence. The most important In the V18, that is 18 leaf stage, we can observe the collar neck of the leaf, and here you can observe the lower part of the plant and upper part of the plant. How the difference between the lower part and the upper part? Upper part of the plant will be having the silk like this at this stage of V18. Coming to the next stage, tassel stage, VT, where it shows the tassel is fully emerged at 2 to 3 days prior to the silking. The plant is at full height and all leaves have emerged like this in the image. And hail damage is most significant at tasseling and can result in 100% yield loss if the tassel is lost. So care should be taken that it should not, the hail should not damage the tasseling stage. And beginning of the 4th week period, that is very critical. Silking will generally begin in 2 to 3 days. Stress occurring a few days prior to the tasseling can cause ear development to slow, resulting in lag between pollen shed and silking. This can lead to the barren ears. You can observe the pollen shed, how the pollens are shedded. The process where the pollens are shedded, you can observe here clearly in this image. Coming to the most important stages, that are reproductive stages and kernel development, noted as R stages in the maize reproductive stages. R1 like silking, where the silk starts to emerge and uptake of nutrients is rapid. NPK, that is NPK, watch for the corn borer feeding. Moisture is needed for the pollination. And in the silking stage, silks emerge with the pollen shed at the rate of 1 to 1.5 inches per day. The silks visible outside the husks. Most critical stage in the development of corn plant. Largest yield reduction occurs from the water and nutrients test at R1. It takes 24 hours for the pollen grains to grow down the silk and fertilize the ovule. Once the fertilized, the ovule becomes the kernel. Generally, 2 to 3 days required for this silks to be fertilized on a single ear. Corn earworm moths may be laying eggs on the silk. So you should observe for that eggs and destroy it. And coming to the blister stage, which is R2, where you can observe the ear size is nearly complete and the fertilized silks are starting to dry out. The blister stage occurs 10 to 14 days after the silking. The kernels are small and watery. The silks are browning and dry. The silks will be darker under the heat and water stress. Irrigation and or good soil moisture still critical for grain fill. The starch begins to accumulate in the kernel. Continue to check for bank grass mite in this stage. Coming to the next stage, we have the milk stage, that is R3 stage. In R3 stage, it occurs at 18 to 22 days after the silking. The kernel is yellow color on the outside with a milky fluid. Here you can observe the milky fluid grain in the corn. And kernel growth is now due to cell expansion and the starch accumulation. Corn borer mites may reach the economic thresholds. Coming to the next stage, that is Dow stage, we have the Now let us see about dense stage and mid dense stage, where dense stage is the most kernels have dented on the top. And dense stage generally occurs 35 to 42 days after silking. Cob is dark red color on the majority of hybrids. Coming to the mid dense stage, which is R5.5, the mid dense stage often referred to as half milk line. As the kernels are drying down, a white layer of starch will begin to form, beginning at the top of the kernel and progress to the cob. When this hard layer reaches halfway down the kernel, it is considered to be at the half milk line stage. Coming to the next stage, Now, the last stage, that is physiological maturity stage, you can observe the physiological maturity, also referred to as black layer stage. And the black layer occurs when the starch line has progressed to the base of the kernel, and this can be identified by slicing the kernel and observing the black line that occurs at the kernel base. The minimum dry matter has now accumulated in the kernel. The kernel is about 30 to 35% moisture, and it should be at 13 to 15% moisture for the safe storage. Here you can observe the growth stages of maize. Overall stages, here germination which is occurring, and the plant population established growth point at 20 mm to 25 mm below the surface. And here you can have the weed control process and crop development, active growth leaves and crop development, grass root developments. And next is pollination, 5 to 10 days. And in this stage, you can observe, you can feel the drop dressing and the most important critical moisture requirement at this stages. And the kernel development occurs, the grain filling of nutrients occurs. And the after this all, next coming to the physiological maturity and the mass of the grain, you can observe here in the image, and the ready for the harvest at for 14% moisture, and 13% moisture should be for the safe storage. And these are the growth stages of maize.
If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.